Actually, lizards are the closest relatives to mammals that are able to regenerate an appendage in their tail. We are basically comparing what happens in mammalian wound healing processes to those in lizards, identifying the differences as well as the similarities to try to bring mammals closer to reptiles in terms of their wound healing abilities. I grew up in Toms River, New Jersey, which is a shore community. My parents have lived there all their lives. And my dad is in real estate, and he would sell houses, and sometimes there'd be turtles and lizards in these houses, so he'd bring them home for me. And then I joined the local herpetological society, which was a bunch of like elderly guys who also studied reptiles and amphibians. I was the youngest member, actually, and I remember in kindergarten I gave like a presentation on breeding the American box turtle. I didn't know it at the time, but it was really good training for using reptiles in science, basically. I did my undergraduate at Johns Hopkins University in biomedical engineering with a minor in chemical engineering and math. For graduate school, I did a joint program between the National Institutes of Health in Maryland and Cambridge University in the UK. So that's where I got my stem cell biology kind of background. And then as I was finishing my graduate education, my mentor, Rocky Tuan at the NIH, was moving to Pittsburgh, and he asked me if I would come along to do a postdoc, which he said, I could pursue, basically gave me a lot of freedom to pursue my own research interests. And that's when I kind of started the lizard project. Cartilage is a tissue that most mammals, and humans in particular, are completely unable to repair, let alone regenerate. In the back of my mind, I had always known, well, lizards regenerate their tails, and their regenerated tail skeleton is almost completely cartilaginous. So lizards are really good at regenerating cartilage. So I thought it was perfect. Did some studies on cartilage development within the regenerating lizard tail. Published a paper, then applied for an R01 grant from the NIH. Was awarded that, and that's how I got my faculty position at Pitt, and then it's probably why I was recruited to USC. So there's some amazing lizard species out there. We have four species of lizard in the lab currently. The one that we primarily work with is called the mourning gecko. So this is an all-female species of gecko that reproduces asexually to yield clonally identical offspring. This is very important and a nice feature for science because we can take cells and tissues from any member of our lizard colony and apply it to any other member without rejection. When your model organisms are all genetically identical, your experimental results are tighter, and you're able to detect changes that might not be detectable with a more genetically varying species. We also have two other species of lizards in the lab, the crested gecko and the sarasinorm gecko. So these are two species of lizard that are close enough in relationship that they can hybridize, but they have divergent regenerative capabilities. So the crested gecko can't regenerate its tail naturally, whereas the sarasinorm gecko can. And we have found that when we crossbreed these two lizard species, their hybrids can regenerate their tails. The fourth species that we have in the lab is the green anole. This is an American lizard and is probably the best annotated genome of any lizard species. So we're using this species to do work like single cell sequencing, ATAC epigenetic sequencing, to try to get at the genetic components for regeneration. There's so many amazing animal abilities. Just in terms of the medical field, there's animals that are resistant to cancer that can regenerate limbs. Almost thinking of them as superpowers, how to translate those superpowers into humans is something I'm really interested in.